morning, Yuri. Well, Yuri! Hey, Chalinka. Huh? Can you at least... Can you be a little less active at least in your sleep? We could. Alright, so, we got introduced to the bad guys of the game. Apparently they have an issue with our dad, I assume. To be fair, I have an issue with our dad too. For one, how do you not notice your children standing there in the plaza? Oh, they're not in my clear line of sight. I'm not gonna walk around the fountain or anything. I'm just gonna run into Old Town and assume they got into trouble. Good job, old man. I assume we have to go to Meath's house. As well as there's like two buildings in it. That's kind of fucking weird. That explains why they gotta go into town to get supplies. Hey! Where's Al? Good morning, Papa!
Good morning, Chalinka. Did you see Yuri sleeping on the floor?
I sure did! I was shocked out of my sleep! How did you end up there, anyway? I don't have a clue. Say, where are you up to? What are you up to, Papa?
Well, I had to set out to organize this library, but with so many books, I was starting to feel discouraged. There were only a few books here back when you two were born, but now it's become quite a collection. Guess it's no surprise that Meath and Alan are so knowledgeable about so many things.
Wow, they've collected these books since after we were born? And read all of them?
There are many different kinds of books here. Feel free to pick and read any one that catches your eye.
Well...
That's okay. Most of them are probably too hard for you to read now anyway. I'm sure you'll find out one day how enjoyable it can be to read books. Must be enjoyable to jump on your head, old man. I have a question though. If you saw your son sleeping on the floor, why didn't you, like, interact with that and be like, hey, the Great Magical Manual, 3rd edition, Magical Expert Explorer Methods of Attracting a Child's Enthusiasm. Oh, there's a Lilty, and Stiltskin is in the pot. Meath is cooking Stiltskin. Is this the globe of the world? Interesting. Meath, my lady, it's so nice of you to draw a morning bath for me. I was sore from my travels, but I'm feeling better already. Ah, life is wonderful. Oh, no need to thank me, Stiltsy. It's equivalent exchangey. You're giving me the stock that I needy. Ah, yes, you're always cooking up a storm, indeed. They say good soup has to start from... Wait, stock? Good morning, kiddies. Good morning, Meath. Have you seen Al? That lanky middle-aged birdie man said he was going to Mount Vale to get some medicinal herbies. Really? When was this? Just a minute or two before you came in. I thought you might have seen him outside. You know what this means, Chalinka? You bet. It's hunting time! Good lucky, tonight's menu is chicken stewy. Ah! Say, Meath, dear. It's getting awfully hot. Think you can turn down the heat a bit? Patience, Stiltsy. You have to wait until the water's bubbly and boily. Ah, she's cooking the Murgle. All clear.
Al.
Al.
I'm afraid not. Oh, come on. It would be impractical. Wounds would be critical. Put you in the hospital.
Oh, all right.
Yippee!
On one condition, you are to follow my instructions to the letter if you to go at all. Yes, sir.
Alright, let's do this.
Now, you must give me your full attention or I'll. Mount Vaal is a locale known by us youths as a training ground to hone our physical and physical mental. Many of our contraptions allow passes solely through the use of our abilities Tri-Vaal. That in mind, let us head for Mount Vaal.
Alright, so we got Al with us. We're going to. Is this Mount Vaal? Yeah, alright.
At last! Our arrival! What do we do? Take a look over there. Oh, it's a Moogle. Almost. It's actually a Moogle plant. A type of vegetation with decoration floral. A full bloom, it closely resembles a Moogle. The pollen distribution method is aerial. So you want us to pick... Wait, who is she, Al? Why is your demeanor quizzical? No need to play dumb with us. Who are the flowers for? Oh, I get it. You finally got a girlfriend. Good for you, Al. Moogle plants are herbal. They're used to make restorative concoction for purposes medicinal. Huh. Okay, whatever you say, Al. Sure, we'll play along. Mum's the word, eh, Al? My sympathy's about your mother, but please pay attention. Ordinarily, the plant is not to us beneficial. But when it blooms, there is a transformation chemical. Only now is it at its optimal. I can see why you'd want to have something for an occasion special. Well, whose birthday is it? Anyway, our purpose here is not to gather Moogle plants as ingredients essential. It's not, then why are you going on about flowers for your girlfriend? That's because... Yeah, how come, Al? If you can't keep up, don't interrupt. We have a singular goal. The Mega Moogle plant, which only grows in cold, elevated climates, like that found here in Mount Vaal. If I calculated the season correctly, we should find it up at the mountain's pinnacle. Okie dokie. Typical. Kubo! I'm glad you're here, Kubo. It's freezing out here, Kubo. Well, let's begin, Kubo. I mean, what a coincidence for us to be meeting like this, Kubo. Let me share the importance to sharing your abilities, the basics of cooperating with your friends in battle, and the Yuke tribe abilities, Kubo. Please share. But first, let me take your items because we don't need them, Kubo. Don't worry, Kubo, I'll give them back when we're done. Poof, Kubo. That was rude. Okay, let's begin, Kubo. I'm gonna explain how to change characters, Kubo. Now that you have Allenham in your party, a character panel for Allenham has been added to the left side of the bottom screen. You can use this to switch from Yuri to Allenham, Kubo. To change the panel, just touch the panel of the character you want to control, Kubo. You now have switched from controlling Yuri to controlling Allenham, Kubo. Sometimes characters during your adventures, the characters that you don't control may get lost, Kubo. If that happens, call them over, but just press L to call them over to where you are, Kubo. Hold L and your friends will all follow wherever you go, Kubo. Would you like me to go over that again? Let's move on. Now, let me explain about piling rings magic L. Piling magic involves two or more rings in an effort. Cooperation L. When piled, the resulting magic is more powerful than what could be produced by a single ring, or a ring single. To pile magic with an ally, you must first select a magic site and produce a target ring. At which time, the panel of any character who's able to pile the magic on your ring will start reacting in a phenomenon of light sympathetical. While on this state, touch the panel of the character with magic pliable, or magic pileable, to have your ally produce another ring, target ring, to pile on additional. When the rings meet, they'll start shining bright, at which point you can activate the effect Magical, the result of which would be a magic more powerful. Let us finish our spell trial. 1, 2, 3! Boom, Fyra. I should have been visible. The piled spell Magical dealt more damage than normal. The ally's magic set usable remains just as it was prior to changing characters to controllable. It may be wise to set in advance the magic set for each character to pile spells Magical. Of course, care is needed since sufficient quantity of magic sets is required to pile rings Magical. Would you like to study once more the pilings of rings Magical? No, next. Then we are done with the piling magic tutorial. Next, allow me to explain about magic threads, the Yuke's ability tribal. This is called a mage's needle, a pole with a storage of magical powers, or a storage of powers magical. By drawing magic power from it, we can activate various contraptions magical. For instance, we could draw a magic thread from the mage's needle to light the candle magical. Would you like to see how to once more how to light the candle magical? No. Then I want you to demonstrate to me that you are sufficiently knowledgeable. Use the touchscreen by lighting the other candle magical. With both candles lit, the barrier has disappeared. We can now proceed through the portal. The magical thread can activate many other contraptions magical. By the way, at the expense of SP, we can also draw threads from a magic site for our magical attack magical. The knowledge may someday prove useful. This concludes the explanation on the Yuke's ability tribal. Then let us go harvest the Mega Moogle plant on the summit of Mount Vaal. My work here is done, Kippo. Farewell, Kippo. I don't think we're going to be finishing this dungeon today, but I will say this. I like the music. It is very much Crystal Chronicles. It reminds me of some of the areas in the first game that we played there. Let's hop over to the area for a sec. So this is where my other file is. It's a bit further along in terms of levels, I guess, but I can just get levels off stream, so. Unlike the first. Alright. Let's stock up on Magicite. So it costs, you get one set of items for each character. Or, not each character, but for the group. Each character pulls from that group. Piss off! White dust! That's true. Again this way. I got a secret disguise. Got another weak aura pack for the whole instance. That's kind of cool. Interesting. More treasure up there. A steel weapon. No passes due to avalanche, K-Pal.
We're gonna explore as much of the dungeon as we can at this point, but I don't think I'm gonna have time to finish it right now. I have to go to a meeting at 2:30. And it's 14 minutes till that starts. Oh shit, I thought that was dead. Hey, level 10. I'm almost caught up to my other character. Too far behind it. We're almost caught up story-wise, so. Maybe it'll open up another path for us to make it quicker. Wherever there's a magic needle, there's always some mechanism to activate with a magic thread, Kibal. Use a Yeast tribe ability to find a target for a magic thread. Thank you. So I think I So I didn't have to run all the way over there. But, good to know. So if I need to get back up there, I can use that to get up there. Alright. Now we're gonna go through this other door over here. This is to call my youth friend. Good old Alan Helm. Got another weak aura pack. Yay, trade for both my healing weapons. Excellent. So it appears monsters respawn every time you leave an area. So I think this might be the final zone of the original game. That sounds familiar. If you recall, that's where the meteor hit, and that's where we fought the parasite meteor, and subsequently the end boss. But evidently the meteor has not hit yet, so... Oh shit. But yeah, because the meteor hasn't hit yet, this mountain appears to be in the same order shape it was before. Hopefully there's no meteor parasite there, just naturally. And they just thought it came in the meteorite. But if that was the case, it would be spawning miasmas and the world would be dead, so... I don't think that's accurate. Market closed. If you listen closely, the bombs actually start ticking. Freeze! Darn it. Sorry, buddy. Another Google plan. There we go. It's full and clear magicites too. Alright, so I'm capped on all the magicites, so that's cool. So I think it's time I leave the dungeon here, and we'll come back tomorrow and finish it off and proceed through a good portion of the game. So today we finished off Old Town, which isn't bad. That took a bit. Another removal plant. Wait a sec, I have an idea. I wonder. Okay, so it does do something, but. Okay, I don't see what it does, but I'll figure it out later. Trial and error, trial and error. So let's run out of the mountain down here and. Guys, we gotta leave. I'd stick around and fight you, but. Alright. Can I go to Rabina Tora? One more thing before we're done. We're gonna head over to the. To the weapon shop, but I think we should go over to this person first. Sorry for the wait, welcome to the workshop, making items by hand with the extra special. Oh, hello, sweetie, what do you want, Yuke? Want an extreme display of discrimination, Trabal. Take your time, look around. You, hurry it up, will ya? Alright, that was rude. Custom made iron sword. I'll take it. Still is a buff, but whatever. Secret disguise. Only have one silk. I got a steel weapon too, though. I guess I should look at all the gear I get. Need another silk. Need lots of silk, apparently. Now let's make the steel weapon first. A bastard sword. Oh, I got an HP boost. Yeah, I'll use that. There you go. Alright, so I can make rugged clothes, blue headwear, not so hot outfit, secret disguise. Maybe we'll actually see. It's hard to say which one would be best. Secret disguise is one silk. Red heather, blue heather. Rugged clothes. Well, let's get the rugged clothes first. Green clothes. Well, I can't use them and they're not better for the Uke. Alright.
not hot outfit. Okay, let's make the red headwear. Made a red hat, which is better for the Allen helm. Okay. Let's go in. Equipment. Can I not equip? Oh, okay, I see. You're hatless. Well, now you have a red hat. Academic armor is a better attack, but lower defensive magic, so not really worth it. And you get a magic ring. Okay. Oh, you can see the hat on him. Excellent. Staff would be worse for him. Head armor, anything better? Ooh, the novice's salad would be better. Alright, let's get that. Body armor. Novice's harness. Alright, let's get that. There you go. Anything better for this? Just life rings. Okay. I don't know if my armor actually changed. Alright, let's head over, save our game, and we'll be done for today. Hello, Juba. Alright everyone, thank you very much for viewing today. We shall continue this tomorrow. I don't have anything planned otherwise, so thank you for viewing, and we will see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.